morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing of the morning. Praise for them springing fresh from the word. Sweet the rain's new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dewfall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light Eden's a play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day.
Good morning. Thank you, Jody. That was a beautiful song. My name is Robert Bright. I'm the pastor here at Unity Church of El Cajon, and it is a joy and an honor to share this time together for our midweek service. Today we have Linda Burdett, who's going to be offering a time of meditation and prayer, and our own Judy Gaudet will provide a message to warm your heart. Would you join me right now in prayer? We give thanks to you, loving God. We give thanks to you for your blessings in our lives. We thank you for the ability to notice those blessings and to claim the good in all things. And right here and right now, dear God, we accept our good as it is opening up before us. That as we look out into the world, each and everything that we see is good. And we see more good. And we claim and call that good by name. We are grateful, dear God, to be living in community with others, that we are interacting and that we are connecting in a very deep way. We know that you are providing the avenues for that to manifest. Thank you, dear God, for blessing us here and now. In the name and in the nature of the living Christ, we claim this. Amen. Today's daily word is renew. This is March 25th. The affirmation for renew is, I am refreshed and restored. Peace and tranquility are qualities that are part of the spiritual blueprint that exists deep within my soul. If I feel discouraged or anxious, I remember that love and peace of God are always with me. My thoughts have the power to renew my mind. Affirming peace by filling my conscious mind with loving, calming thoughts leaves me feeling refreshed and restored. I continue to nourish myself with notions of peace that permeate my thoughts, words, and actions. I am sure to get quality rest, spend time in nature, and exercise my body. I also allow my mind to be renewed and revitalized through the power of prayer. We are offered this scriptural lesson from Romans 12:2. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect.
Thank you, Robert. That was beautiful. invite you to join me now in a time of meditation. Settle back in whatever you're sitting in, whatever position serves you, and just relax. Take a breath with me, easily and gently. And in this breath, we know that we are renewed. This breath that we take, that we share, energizes us, fills our blood, fills our life with being, with presence, with celebration. Let us take this knowing, this joy, deeply into this silence. And with our next breath, let us begin to bring ourselves back into the here and now, refreshed, renewed, reinvigorated. Perhaps we'll stretch and move around again and be grateful that we share this time and this place with one another. And so it is.
Thank you, Linda. This week's midweek message is one of joy, one of excitement, because you're coming home. And that's the title of the message today. And the verse that I'm going to use is, I go and prepare a place for you, and where I go, you will also be there. What does that mean? What did it mean to you as a kid? I think we all went through various stages of, what are they talking about? Is it something, this place, where is it? Is it something that happens after I die? And if you're like me, all through the years, I've wondered about it, but yet I've just sort of put it out of my mind because I couldn't comprehend what it was talking about. And where is this place? And in the next few moments, I want to share some thoughts with you about where this place is and what it is and what it can mean for you. And if I give you some nuggets to take with you that make your life a different life, then this message has done its job. In going to prepare a place for you, God is saying, I go and make a new state of consciousness that must come into visibility, that must materialize. The days of mentally living in heaven and physically dwelling in a hell of beliefs are over. They must be over. That which is true in consciousness must also have its material counterpart, where the two become one. And you remember the verse, where what God has joined together, let no man, no beliefs, nothing, put them asunder. What I'm going to share with you in the next few moments is your wedding feast. What it means to be joined. Rejoice in it, because what happens is when you are joined, the Word becomes flesh. You are that flesh. But how? How do you get there? How do you prepare for your wedding? What must change? There is another verse that says, there must be a new heaven and a new earth. That means that the old must pass away to make room. I don't know about you, but as long as I'm holding on to stuff, nothing new can come in. There's no room for it. And you stay stuck. You stay stuck in a job. You stay stuck in a relationship. You're stuck because you're holding on. You've got to be willing to take a chance. You've got to be willing to risk everything. And it's an emptying out process. And when I say everything, I mean everything. Everything must go. All the systems you've known, all the creeds, all the beliefs, all the cults, all the teachers, all of it, that must take place. You must empty out. Make room for the new. You know, I lived with the thought, what if I do that? What if I surrender to this God that I wasn't even sure I understood, or let alone had a huge relationship? What's going to happen to me? What am I going to be like? Who am I going to be? People are frightened to do that. They don't realize, and this is something that took forever to learn, at least for me, is this was never really you in the first place. What you were wearing was a mask of your own making. The real you got lost way back when. And I'm sure you all remember the story of the little boy who went into his new baby sister's room and said, tell me what it's like. I've forgotten. What do you think he was saying? What do you understand about that? What did this little boy know at one time and had now forgotten? We've all forgotten. We've all been asleep. But you, what this little boy was remembering was you came with gifts. You came with talents. You came with what we call spiritual gifts, because you're a spirit having a human condition, having a human experience. That spirituality came in the ways of gifts of love, of wisdom, intuition, enthusiasm, joy, and so much more. They're yours. And instead of depending upon them, you turned your life to those around you, which is so totally, totally believable. It's so totally understandable. They influenced you. They became your God. Life around you became your God. You lost that connection. That's what that little boy was asking, because he knew deep down inside that there was something else. And how many of you have lived all your life knowing that there's something else? There's something missing. I know I kept studying all the books, and I still do today because I still get nuggets. But I knew something was missing. And what I knew was that everything else will pass away for there to be a new heaven. And what is left is your relationship with God. So how do you get there? How do you get there? You ask. You say, I give up. I give up because something doesn't make sense. And what doesn't make sense? You don't feel whole. You feel like two different people. You feel so confused by things. What's true? What's not true? And as was stated in another message I heard earlier, truth doesn't pass away. Truth doesn't change. Books, relationships, beliefs, creeds, they all pass away. What are you left with? You're left with the truth you have found. You are left, it is between you and God. Each of us will journey on a highway. And we have to do this journey alone, or at least we start this journey alone. For me, it was like jumping off a cliff. I'll never forget the vision I had of that. And Jesus was over the cliff. He was down the cliff. And I remember hearing it as clear as if you were talking to me. Jump, I'll catch you. It took a lot of years to jump. It took a lot of years, a lot of chaos, a lot of pain to say, I trust you. I trust my life with you. So each of us has our own highway. But what's interesting is once you say yes to the highway, you're going to find other people who are on the same journey you are. They may have gotten there in a whole different way. They had different experiences, different stories they can tell, different heartaches, but they got there. And they're joining you. You don't have to go seek them. They will be attracted to you. You will be attracted to them. Just as you don't have to make the changes in your life. You have to allow the changes in your life. It's not easy, but it is simple if you let it. Or else, if you try to force it, you will not get there. You must have patience and allow the Christ within you that you have become aware of that said, I am making a place for you. I am giving you a new state of consciousness. And as you dwell in this, and as you travel this highway, that level of consciousness will change. It will continue to change as you surrender more and more and more of your life. As you say, take over. Take this. I'm willing to let go because this no longer serves me. New things come about. Things start showing up in your life in different ways and in different ideas, different creativity. You find yourself speaking different words, words that were never part of your vocabulary. It becomes different because you're coming home. You're becoming. You're going back to who you really are. It means that you are standing on your tiptoes of your greatest awareness. It means a life that is full. It doesn't mean that everything will be just perfect, but what it means is that you'll be using the tools that you came into this life with, the 12 powers. You'll be using those to run your life. You will know instinctively how to handle situations. You will know. Because if you trust the scripture that I read to you, I go and prepare a place for you, and where I am, you will be there also. Then you know without a doubt that you have come home and come back to who you really, really are. And with this we pray. We just thank you, beloved Father, for this time, for these words that have been given to the people that are listening, that they go about their week with the joy and the hope and the excitement of knowing there is so much more to life, so much more to who they are, and that they will know they have just forgotten, and you have given them the opportunity to press their claim and claim that they were made in your image. And so it is.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. He speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet, the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is ringing. And he with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has. has ever known. I'd stay in the garden with him, though the night around me be falling. But he bids me go through the voice of woe. His voice to me is calling. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever.
Hi there. Now for a few announcements. First of all, Silent Unity is available to you 24 hours a day, 365 days of the year. To be with you in prayer, we invite you to call 816-969-2000. Again, 816-969-2000. Allow someone to pray with you of your prayer concern. Also, our office is open, and we would like to pray with you as well. Our chaplains are available for prayer support. We invite you to call our office number at 619-579-9586. We'll take your prayer requests, and a chaplain will get back to you as soon as possible. Our office is open for calls and email inquiries. If you'd like to be a part of our mailing list and or our email newsletter, we invite you to call and give us your information. We'd like to have your email address. We want to thank you for supporting this church with your tithes and offerings. We appreciate those of you who have been sending them in. If you would like to contribute at this time and support this ministry, we invite you to send your checks to Unity Church of El Cajon, 311 Highland Avenue, El Cajon, California, 92020. You can also call us with your credit card, a MasterCard Visa contributions as well. Again, our number is 619-579-9586. We want you to know that we are with you. We are holding you in prayer. We are loving you. We want to be of service to you. Please let us know how we can reach in and reach out to you. Our email address is admin@unityofelcajon.org. Again, admin@unityofelcajon.org. Our Facebook page is available. Our website is available. We are constantly updating on all formats. Thank you for being here.
Peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be with God as Creator. Family, all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my joyous vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Please join me in the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. And all is well. Amen.